We've spent much time speculating about the idea of a playable Zelda in a Zelda game. So now, to be looking at a Zelda game and speculating about a playable Link, that's funny. That's really funny. ESRB, our good friends at the ESRB, they don't get a lot of opportunities to spill beans, but when they got beans, they gotta spill them. They gotta do it. And it seems that potentially the little rating summary of Echoes of Wisdom on the ESRB website, it might have revealed that Link will be playable in some way, some capacity, in Echoes of Wisdom. The little paragraph for Echoes of Wisdom just talks about Zelda and what she does, but it's got an interesting little tidbit in the middle. You know, it starts, "This is an adventure game in which players assume the role of Zelda as she attempts to dispel rifts throughout Hyrule and rescue Link. From a three-quarters overhead perspective, players explore various environments while fighting stylized enemies, e.g. humans, creatures. As Link, players use a sword and arrows to defeat enemies. Zelda can use a magic wand to summon creatures for battle, etc." And I mean, I've seen some people speculate that it's kind of a misunderstanding where, oh, well, normally as Link, they use a sword and arrows, but in this case, Zelda uses magic. I really don't see it that way. This does seem to confirm that in this game, at some point, you will play as Link. So then, from there, the most popular school of thought is that this is just talking about the beginning of the game. Like the intro, you know, the reveal for the game showed Link, he's fighting Ganon, and then he gets sucked into a rift, and then it becomes Zelda's thing. So it could be that the player plays through some sort of, like, intro to the game as Link, and then Zelda takes over. And that is certainly possible. However, I'm skeptical of this idea, because Nintendo is all about, like, intuitively teaching the player. They want someone to be able to, like, pick up the game and pretty early on understand what you're doing and how to play it. So it's hard for me to imagine a scenario where Nintendo releases a game where at the beginning of the game, you play briefly as a character with their own complete moveset, their own completely unique style. Like, starting there and expecting the player, you know, assuming it's maybe a newer player or something, expecting them to learn this character and learn these controls and these mechanics, learn how this character interacts with the world around them, and then take it away and start with another new one, with another completely new character with a completely new set of abilities. That, to me, does not seem likely. Nintendo doesn't want you to learn something that you are not then going to use. So, sure, I may be looking way too deep into this, but my gut tells me that this means there will be sections of this game where you genuinely play as Link. And it's not just a tutorial, it's not just a little for funsies kind of thing, but in some way you are playing as Link as a way to move through the game. That is not to say that I think Link is going to be like one of the primary main characters and you're going to spend like a really significant amount of time as him. That doesn't seem super likely, especially because notice that it says as Link, players use a sword and arrows. And of course, they're not going to go into like all the details. They're not going to be spoiling every like item or ability you might get in the game here in this little description. But couldn't you imagine that if this game is mainly about Zelda, but sometimes you play as Link, or maybe during one sequence you play as Link, it's like just the sword and arrows? I could see that. If you want to boil down Link to his most simple elements, especially like top-down Link, what's he got? He's got a sword and he's got arrows and like probably a shield, but he doesn't necessarily need a hookshot or any of these other, you know, Pegasus boots or whatever. I could see there being sequences that are a little bit simpler, maybe as a way to just kind of supplement the Zelda gameplay You get to play as Link sometimes. And the thing about this game is that Link has been sucked into one of these rifts, and Zelda has to save him. But we don't know what part these rifts are going to play in the world. And I could see there being this thing where you're kind of switching back and forth every once in a while. Maybe you're Zelda, you're Zelda most of the time, but then maybe there are sequences, maybe between chapters, like Paper Mario style, where you're in this weird rift world wherever it takes you, whether it's a third dark world or something. Would not put it past Nintendo to just have another one, just another, a third alternate world on top of the two that they've already got. And maybe you are doing something. Maybe, if you really want to get deep about it, maybe they're helping each other. Maybe what Link does, helps Zelda in the overworld, or what Zelda does helps Link. And if this happened, I love the idea, but if it happened, it would be too funny. Way too funny, because this is exactly what we were dreaming up for Tears of the Kingdom. This is where this whole, Zelda being playable speculation really kicked into high gear, because the reveal trailer and even the subsequent trailers for Tears of the Kingdom showed Zelda falling into an abyss, clearly being separated from Link, and then Link is up on the overworld and he's playing the game, running around, and we're like, where is Zelda? And if she is playable, that brings to mind maybe these little sequences where you're Zelda and she's underground. She's lost somewhere, but you still have these playable sequences as her, and maybe they're even helping each other. Maybe what she does helps Link up there. I still think it's an amazing idea, and I still wish that that's what Tears of the Kingdom was, because what we got was not as good as that. That idea was a lot more interesting than what they actually did with it. Well, that's a whole conversation for another day. So if that is what this game ends up being, except with the roles reversed and Link is the one that was sucked down into the abyss and is playable, even though he's not the main character of the game, that's really funny. And if that did happen, I would have to wonder if that genuinely came from Aonuma and the team just being on the internet and seeing everybody else propose this idea. And they were like, darn, you know what? That's a great idea. That's a really good idea. So now we're doing this Zelda game starring Zelda. Hey, let's take that idea, that whole thing of splitting them up, but you can play as both. I don't know. At this point, it's not even worth speculating too much more, because we really don't know what this means. It really could be that even if you do play as Link at some point, it could be one sequence, and it could be something so simple. It could be so simple that you're not even really expecting the player to really get it. You're not going to have Link fighting loads of enemies and having to use his sword and his arrows in really complex ways. It could be just little story sequences where you're like, oh, you just gotta go through a couple rooms and do it. It could be something very simple. Or another theory, just while we're here, while we're talking about it, while we're theorizing, the whole entire point of the game is to rescue Link. What if at some point you do rescue Link, but then he gets to come to the overworld and you kind of get, or maybe even after the credits, maybe there's post-game content or something where you've been interacting with the world this whole entire time as Zelda, but now Link gets to go up there and you just kind of you get another run. You have something that you have to do as Link, but now it's changed. Now you have the same world, maybe even some of the same items that Zelda's put up there. Maybe that's part of the teamwork element or something. But now you have Link and it recontextualizes everything. Maybe you end up saving Link before the end of the game, and after that point, you switch back and forth, and now that would be amazing. What if that was an element that they just haven't revealed yet, but they'll reveal later, or you have to play the game to know it? It's at first you start as Zelda, but then at some point you rescue Link, and now you can switch back and forth, and now she's creating items, and Link is using these items in some way. I don't know. Probably not gonna happen. I just like thinking. I just like dreaming about this stuff. There's just so many cool things that they could do with it, and I know that it's not even worth doing, because it's probably the same thing with Tears of the Kingdom. Oh man, we're getting these little hints. Maybe it's like this, maybe it's like that, maybe this amazing thing, and then you play the game and you're like, nah, they didn't do it. They were not interested in playing with the concept the same way that some of us were. So I know, I'm not gonna get my hopes up, but all that to say, at the very least, it does seem like Link will be playable in some way. If it's not a significant way, then that, I'm trying to imagine how that would go. Because again, I don't think Nintendo wants you to learn how to play as Link and then not spend a significant amount of time playing with Link. So if he's playable in the game at all, that makes me think that it's got to be a little meatier than just a simple little tutorial. It's got to be at least a little bit more substantial. Either that, or it's gonna be crazy simple. It's gonna be so simple that you basically don't, no player would have to learn anything. It'd just be some very, very rudimentary sword and arrow shooting gameplay. Whatever the case though, I'm excited to find out. 2 months. 2 months now. It's already basically been a month since the Direct. July, August, September. Comes out in September. I cannot. My brain cannot accept it. Like, it was just announced and it was already so mind-blowing and amazing. And now, 2 months? I'm used to, like, you announce it and it's like next year sometime. 2020 question mark? I don't know. 2 months, we'll be playing this game. I'd say I can't wait, but I don't even have to wait. I've blinked and now it's been a month. I just have to blink two more times and it'll be here.